So you're looking to spray foam your basement walls, but should you use open cell or closed cell? Let's talk about it. So you're looking to spray foam your basement walls, but you're not sure if you should use open cell or closed cell. Well, there's a few things to keep in mind that may push you one way or the other. Before we get into that, you know I need you to go below and hit that thumbs up button for us. Thanks. So the first thing I want to address is the one key factor that would determine if you should go open cell or closed cell. And that's if you're going to finish the basement off or not. If you're going to put up drywall or any type of finishing on top of those basement walls, then I would recommend open cell. However, if you're going to leave those walls exposed for any reason, then I would recommend closed cell 100% of the time. The reason is that closed cell has that durability and that rigidness that really will make it last over time. Of course, you're going to bump into these walls various different ways. It will happen, and open cell will get damaged over time, and it can flake off. Chunks can get torn off. If you're trying to move furniture and you rub against the wall, that open cell will get damaged. Whereas that closed cell, because it's so durable, it will be fine. So again, if you're going to have your basement walls exposed, you definitely should use closed cell. If you're going to finish off the basement walls, use open cell. Let's talk about why both would do just fine. Well, both products provide an air seal. Both products absolutely establish that building envelope, both open cell and closed cell, so there's no real advantage one way or the other. Both provide excellent thermal resistance. So again, you're not getting a strong advantage there either way. And lastly, both have incredible longevity. Both products would be warranted to last the lifetime of the building. You're not going to get aging, cracking, or settling with either open cell or closed cell. So when you're looking at this as a performance standpoint, there's really no tangible benefit to using open cell over closed cell or vice versa. Generally speaking, closed cell will be a little bit more expensive than open cell. Now, for a basement wall, it probably won't be enough cost to really push you one way or the other, but that's something to keep in mind. Now, with that being said, if for any reason you want the spray foam to be very thick, I mean, I'm talking 5+ inches of spray foam, now your cost for the closed cell gets driven up really quickly, because a closed cell per inch will be much more expensive, especially when you're starting to talk about that deep of foam. Now, the reason is closed cell takes a lot longer to spray when you're at that depth. So of course that cost will get drawn up as well. Of course, closed cell is just a little bit more expensive than open cell to begin with. So the last thing I want to point out is we get a lot of people that say they want to use closed cell in a crawl space or in a basement in this situation because it has good moisture control. Now, they will say that closed cell is waterproof and that you can use it to prevent leaks. I would never ever recommend using closed cell for this purpose. If you have moisture issues in your basement, you need to address that first. Having closed cell as a moisture solution is never a reason to use that to insulate the basement. Again, address those issues separately. But looking back over everything we spoke about, there is no real performance difference between open cell and closed cell. Cost is pretty close. Closed cell might be a little bit more. And the only thing that would really push you hard one way or the other is if you're going to finish off those walls or leave them exposed. So at the end of the day, that's all you should really look at. If you're going to finish the walls, use open cell. It works just as well, and you might save a little bit more money. If you're going to leave the walls exposed, definitely go closed cell. That durability will come in handy. If you want to learn more about how you should insulate your basement walls, check out the link below. Don't forget, subscribe to our channel and ring that bell to see all of our notifications.